Who wouldn't really want to build a flying motorcycle? We think this is new leading technology and we're one of the first in it. If you look at Boeing and NASA, other large companies, they're actually looking to break into this industry as well. My name is Joseph Segura Khan. I'm the CTO deputy of HoverSurf, and today I'm going to show you the most extreme manned vehicles. We sell our Scorpion 3, which is essentially a flying motorcycle with no restrictions. You can fly it as high, as fast as you would like. Some really neat things about the Scorpion 3 is, first of all, it's the first manned drone that you can actually pre-order in the United States or the rest of the world. Some other neat things about it is the look and the feel. So it almost looks like a flying motorcycle. So it kind of gains a lot of attention when we're driving around the city or showcasing it. Another neat thing is there's actually no limits with this device. So you can set some constraints where you can actually fly several feet off the ground, or you can free fly it as high as you would like, but be aware. We do have built-in precautions, so you can set it at a certain height so you can be a little bit safer. We can't talk too much about it, a lot of it is secret, but we can give a couple things away. One very neat thing about the Scorpion 3 is that we use current infrastructure that is already in place. So all of our crafts and drones, as well as our formula vehicle, will actually be able to land and take off in a parking spot. Whereas a lot of our competitors actually will need designated areas to take off and land. So we've created a product that actually works with current infrastructure in the city. Our Scorpion 3 can actually fly for 20 minutes. It can fly as far as 13 miles. Again, there's no limit to how high you can go. It's really up to you. The reason we refer to it as a drone is because 90% of the work is being done by our onboard flight system, which is very similar to drones, four blades, but the flight system ensures that you're always level. If any wind comes, it'll auto-correct itself. Also, the pilot can fly it if they would like, but similar to drones, you can actually summon the device to come to you, land. You can actually control it without being on it. So it's very similar to a drone. The only aspect is you're sitting on top of it. We do think that this is an industry that everyone is going to be breaking into, and we do think this is something that a lot of people will be actually using. A lot of companies, again, like NASA and Boeing, are actually looking to break into this market. And so we feel that in a couple of years, a lot of people will actually be using flying motorcycles, flying cargo drones to deliver products to people or to actually help people in need. One of our crafts was actually sold to the Dubai Police Department. And they currently have a Scorpion 3 in their police fleet that they will use in emergency situations. So I do not own one, but I have flown it, and it's one of the most amazing things you'll ever get to experience. I mean, imagine sitting on a motorcycle, but it flies around. So the first time I flew this, it was actually quite exhilarating. To be able to sit on a flying motorcycle and actually go as high as you want, as fast as you want, with no limitations, there's really nothing like it. You won't really experience something like this ever in your life. Last week, we actually were in New York for New York Fashion Weeks with Philip Plane, and we showcased this flying drone part of his show. It was a very amazing show, and it's something that we want to just keep showing the rest of the country as we travel to California.